How many squares? Chapter 3. In this chapter, we mainly concentrate and we are going to learn about area and perimeter. In the last class, in the introduction class of this chapter, in advance I discussed what is the meaning of perimeter and area. So with the help of the previous knowledge, we are going to do the lesson now. This is a graph paper design I have drawn. First concentrate here. When I inform, then only do in the graph book. Right now I'm not doing the graph book. For 5 to 10 minutes, concentrate here, listen, try to answer, then we will use the graph book. Okay, no hurry. First concentrate here. Silence and concentrate. As I said in the last class, perimeter of any shape is the length of the boundary. This length of the boundary is called perimeter. The surface it is occupied is called area. The surface it occupies is called area. Area is the surface occupied by the shape, and boundary of the shape is called perimeter. Now, this is a graph. Here, one shape is drawn. One shape is drawn here. You can see the shape, no? Here, one shape is drawn. Now, two questions I am going to ask. What is the perimeter of the shape? What is the area of the shape? What is the perimeter? What is the area? Since this we are doing in the graph paper, every box is of 1 centimeter length. Every box is of 1 centimeter in breadth. 1 centimeter length. 1 centimeter breadth, you can see in the graph paper. It is always 1 centimeter and 1 centimeter. Coming to perimeter, perimeter is the total boundary. So 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter, 1 centimeter. So 1 plus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Total 8 centimeter is the perimeter of this shape. Total 8 centimeter is the perimeter of it. What is the area? Area means the surface occupied. See, box. One box. One box is always the area of one box. 1 centimeter length, 1 centimeter breadth. It is a square. Square is side into side. That is 1 centimeter square. Or 1 square centimeter. Always remember, area of one box is always 1 square centimeter. Square centimeter is the unit used for area. If it is in centimeters, square centimeters. If it is in meters, it will be square meters. Square means we are taking two, multiplying one unit, one length, one breadth, one into one. So the area of one box is always 1 square centimeter. Now here, how many small boxes are there? How many small boxes are there?
Four.
Four boxes are there. So area will be 4 square centimeter. 4 square centimeter. So whenever a diagram is given, any diagram is given, to find the area, you have to count how many full boxes are there. Now, here, look at this diagram. Try to find the perimeter and area by counting the number of boxes. Area, by counting the
boxes. The area is 6. Area is 6.
So the area is 6.
Perimeter and area, both let me find. Area is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6.
Six sir, the perimeter is 12.
Number
sir,
of
the perimeter is 12.
Very good. Number of full boxes is giving the area that easily you are able to count. Now, if any problem is given in the graph, you have to see how many full boxes are there. Full boxes only to be counted. Now, coming to the perimeter, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. 12 centimeters. Clear? So this,
yes,
is the, this is the method to find the perimeter and to find the area. If you are ready with this, now let us do some problems in the graph paper. Are you ready?
Sir, if there are half,
very good doubt. If there are half squares, we will neglect half and below squares. We will consider half and above squares. If irregular shapes came, for example, there is a diagram like this. What is the area of this? One full box. This is
just four area.
This is more just than four. This we consider. This is more than half. This is small. We won't consider. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 square units.
Five square centimeters.
Half but that above will be considered. Half below will not be considered. When irregular shapes are there, exact area you won't get. Approximate only we will calculate. Then 50% of the box will be considered. Small boxes are neglected in that case. Anyhow, when we come across, we will see that. Right now, let me share one PPT. In that, we have problems and everything.
Okay. Sir, should we do it in our graph book?
I will tell. When the problem comes, then only. Till that time, let's listen. So, how many squares? Chapter 3, we are going to start. Area. Area means, we know the definition. Area that is defined as a space occupied by a flat shape. Surface occupied. How much surface it occupies is called area. Surface occupied is called area. This already did in the last class. Perimeter means the distance around the figure, the boundary. What I said, boundary. The distance around the figure. Okay. Perimeter of a closed figure is the length of. If it is a closed figure, the length of the total boundary will be that. Now look at this. You can try this in the graph paper. Start doing this in graph paper.
Okay, sir.
Here one shape is mentioned. Try to find the area and perimeter. Answer is already there, but you try on your own. Yes, in the graph paper, start doing this. You can do in the half of the graph paper. Total graph paper don't use. We will get many problems, many diagrams are going to come.
So like this?
I can't see, ma. Bring near to the camera, and only I can see. Here one shape is drawn. Draw the shape in the graph paper neatly. Using colors is your choice. First to do with pencil. Afterwards, if you want, you can do the colors.
So first we have to write this by pencil.
Yes. Coloring can be done later. Yes, Sisifa, correct. Now, count the length of the boundary and the number of boxes.
So where should we write the area is equal to and perimeter is equal to?
Below the graph itself. How
yes, I wrote sir.
Below the graph, two lines.
Okay.
Below the graph itself, we can do it. or
let's say opposite
or some other side of the empty space where you can do it. See, the graph paper is like this, graph book is like this. Here graphs, here you can draw the graph one, here same question number one, write the answer. Perimeter area graph left side, answer right side. That is the method to use the graph paper. If you want, you can write the answer here only, then this paper page will be left. Graph left side, answer right side, answer right side. Question number 1. Yes, your lines are there, no? Single lines are there, there you can write the answer.
Pen.
Perimeter is 20, I think, no?
Sir, we have to write answers down or up.
Answer, I told you, answer you have to write on the other side of this space. Other side of the graph space. Here, this side.
Lines page, sir. We have to write in lines page, sir.
Yes, you have to write in the line space. Background on left side, answer on right side. Yes.
Sir?
Yes.
We have to write area of the shape and the perimeter of the shape in the right page,
right,
or in the
right
left
page? Right page, right page. Right side.
Okay, sir. Thank you. Okay, sir.
Sir, I wrote this one here. So should I write the answer here?
Here means where?
The other side, right side.
See, left side graph, right side answer.
Yes.
That is the method to use the graph. Yes, Sucheta, correct. Correct,
okay,
correct, sir. Correct. Don't forget to put the number. Question number one there, question number one here. Question number should be same on both right and left. Vishwanath, Vikas, switch on your video.
Done, sir. Sir, here is my graph and here is the answer.
Sir, you have to draw, sir.
Wait, I will tell you. Don't be in a hurry.
Sir, fourth page, sir.
How many squares?
Sir, once open fourth page, sir.
Fourth page. Why the fourth page?
Sir, fourth page is done, sir.
This is the
fourth page. Yes, sir, it's done.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
Now, this is a graph. Of course, lines are not here. You are asked to draw the rectangles which contains 12 squares.
Yes.
So how many rectangles we have to draw?
It is your choice.
Yeah, it could make.
There should be. You can draw different. There should be 12 squares, 12 small boxes inside. There should be 12 small boxes inside. 12 small boxes. 12 small boxes needed. How many different rectangles can be made? One full graph paper can be used for that.
Have to draw the box that has to make rectangle.
Yes, rectangle shape. Length and okay, width should be different.
First, then we have to make a little small boxes which have to be there, like 12 of them.
Small boxes will be already there in the draft paper, no? See, I will do.
Yes.
I will do here. Then you will get the idea. Twelve boxes are needed. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. This is one rectangle.
Sir, we can make any small boxes, and we have to make 12 of them.
Your choice. This is one rectangle I am making. Okay. Next. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. This is one more I'm making. In the same graph paper, you can make many number of varieties. Three and four. This is four and three, like this.
Sir, I had made by 12 squares.
12 boxes are there, no?
Sir, I had made by using 12 boxes.
Yes, 12 boxes. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 12 boxes are there.
Okay, sir. Can I make more like this?
Yes.
Can I make more like this?
One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12. Nine.
So I had made two of them.
I have given three shapes here.
Six, So like this.
Like this means?
Anji? Anji? Prepare the sudal one. Anji? Speaker one.
Malay one.
Anji?
One, two,
three, four shapes I prepared here.
Sorry,
but
I have four of them.
Four rectangles, each rectangle containing 12 boxes. You can find some different also. I find two of them.
అట్లా డౌట్ ఉన్నప్పుడు డాట్ లు పెట్టేశాను అన్న ఫస్ట్ కౌంట్ చేసుకొని డౌట్ లు
పెట్టుకోవాలి
రైట్
ఆన్సర్ ఇస్ పర్ఫెక్ట్ ఇఫ్ యు వాంట్ యు కెన్ కలర్ ఇట్ ఆఫ్టర్ వర్డ్
సర్ ఐ యామ్ డన్
ఈ నుంచి చేయి
perimeter. The whole chapter is same. You have to draw the diagram in the graph, find the area, find the perimeter. That's all we are doing in this chapter. First we do perfect shapes, then we do irregular shapes also.
Can you write anything?
Sir, you have to write anything in that.
Now question of this graph from the text is find the area and perimeter of the following figures. Find the area and perimeter of the following figures, following shape. Find the area and perimeter of the following shapes.
Someone unmuted.
We're singing songs in the background.
Sir, you will send PDF this?
It is not the PDF, it is a PPT. I will share the video. I will share the video of the class. Twelve boxes in a row. Find the area and perimeter.
Then
Not use the graph paper and do it.
Okay.
Perimeter means the total boundary. The total boundary is the perimeter. Area is nothing but sum of all small boxes. How many boxes are there of one square unit? That you have to add.
Right.
Sir, I have got the answer 14 and the area is 12.
How you got 14?
Sir, it's 26.
26 is the answer.
Sir, I also got the same answer.
26 is the perimeter, not 14.
Sir, okay, I got it correct now.
I had also got the same as area 12 square centimeters and the perimeter is 26 centimeters.
Correct. 26 is the correct answer.
12
boxes are there here.
Area is 6 centimeters.
Area is always number of boxes. So area is 12 boxes. That is 12 square centimeter. No doubt in it. Add everything. Boundary. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. Again, 12, 24, 25 plus 1, 26. 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, 26 centimeter. Area means the length along the boundary. Perimeter means along the boundary. If this is done, shall we move to the next one?
Yes.
Next one.
20.
Try the next one. What is the area and perimeter of this? Graph on left side, result explanation on right side. That is the procedure you have to follow in the graph. Don't ask again and again. Second question.
Sir, I got the answer.
12 boxes, so area is same, 12 square units. But coming to perimeter, boundary you have to add 6 and 6, 2 and 2.
My drawing page is finished, but I have lines to write.
What now?
Sir, the drawing page, so this page, it's finished in here, but I have lots of page to write.
Then nothing can be done. On the same page, you should have the question and answer. Graph.
Sir, I got 3 centimeters, 14.
Pages are left, okay. Do it in the next phase.
Excuse me, sir. Yes. I got 3 centimeters in a 14 centimeters. Answer.
Where you got 14?
14 square centimeters. See, sir.
Which is that one?
Yes, sir.
First one.
Sir, this one,
I got 16 centimeter only.
16 only you will get, not 14. Check, diagram is there, diagram is in the board, diagram is a shade here. 14 is the wrong answer.
Sir, 3 centimeters, 4 centimeters.
3, 4, from where you got 3, 4? Which question you are talking? We did this question and we are doing this one. Only two questions done till now. Only two questions are done till now. 3 centimeter, 4, from where you are getting? This is done. This we are doing.
Sir, I'm done. And I got 16 centimeters, the answer, sir.
Okay. Next.
Sir, I got perimeter 16 centimeter, area 12 square centimeters.
Next, new shape. Third one.
Sir, third one I did the fourth
one. Fourth one.
Where is the fourth one? This is the third one.
Fourteenth one.
This is the third question. Where is the fourth question? What you are telling, ma'am?
Third question, sir. 14 centimeters.
Yeah, third question is 14 centimeters is the perimeter. Area is 1 square centimeter. That is done. Third question. Do it in the graph paper without any mistakes.
Sir, I got the answer correct. 12.
12 sir, should we do it?
No, already we did this. We already did this. In the above three examples, we already did this. Just comparison. Second question, third question. Second question, third question comparison. Which has the longest perimeter? Question number two and question number three comparison.
Question number one has the longest perimeter. Question number two has the smallest.
26.
Sir, 26 centimeters.
26 is the question number 1, 2, 3. 26 is the highest perimeter. What about smallest perimeter?
It's 16 centimeter.
Smallest. 14 is the no. 14.
Perimeter.
This is the activity I am giving to you. This is the activity I am giving to you. Draw a robot, monster, person, animal, any object on the graph paper. Find the area and perimeter.
Sir, you have to join with boxes only, like this.
Yes. An example is given.
Kind of object. And write that area and perimeter in graph book. Sir, once can you move to the mobile and animal on any kind of object on graph paper and find area and perimeter. Sir, once can you move?
See, this is the activity I'm giving. Take the graph paper, draw the figure so that full boxes should be covered. Like this, full boxes.
Sir, you will say.
Sir, by coloring, we have to cover that person.
You have to draw a picture, anything, monster, robo, animal, person, anything, but it should cover full boxes. Half boxes don't do that. This is the example I'm giving. If you want, I will share this picture, but don't copy this. Try something else.
Okay, sir.
Try something else.
Can we draw our room?
Okay, so that is the activity I'm giving to you. That activity, if you do it, you will get 5 marks in the coming PT1 exam. In the coming month, and you will have a PT1. In that 5 marks I'm giving for this activity. Do it sincerely. Draw the full picture. Full boxes should be covered. It should be some creative figure. Robo, monster, person, animal, something. Some object on the graph paper, draw it, if possible, color it and send to me before the next class. Got my point?
Okay, sir.
Okay. So example is this, like this, full boxes to be covered. Total perimeter and area, both you have to calculate. 5 marks you are going to get in the coming PT1 examination if you do this. The remaining questions are there that we will discuss in the next class. See, some stamps are there, some pictures are there. What is the length of this? What is the breadth of this? What is the area? What is the perimeter? All this we do in the next class. So that is the end of this class. Try this activity at home. Okay, don't forget. Okay. See you in the next class. I hope all marked the attendance.